Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Welcome to episode 14 of 10 Minute Taraweeh. And we begin with our Fatiha fact. Sirat al-ladhina an'amta alayhim. The path of those whom you favored. This makes our minds go back into time. We want to follow the path of those righteous people who went before us, those whom Allah has favored. And this is quite distinct from the idea of progress that always we are looking ahead into the future. We need to be able to take our good examples from the past. Who are the ones whom Allah has favored? They are the ones mentioned in Surah An-Nisa, Surah 4, verse 69. الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ وَالصِّدِّيقِينَ وَالشُّهَدَاءِ وَالصَّالِحِينَ. They are the prophets, the saints, the martyrs, and the righteous in general. So these are the ones whose path we are made to follow. Now we come into Surah Al-Hijr in Juz number 14, which begins, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ألف لام را تلك آيات الكتاب وقرآن مبين ربما يود الذين كفروا لو كانوا مسلمين. This is a vain hope expressed by those who rejected truth in this life when they face the judgment of the next life. They will wish on that day that they had indeed submitted to Allah. And in this first page of Surah Al-Hijr, we have a promise taken by God Almighty that He has taken the responsibility upon Himself to preserve this Qur'an. إِنَّا نَحْنُ نَزَّلْنَا الذِّكْرَ وَإِنَّا لَهُ لَحَافِظُونَ. This is verse 9 of Surah Al-Hijr. Going through in the surah, we find another expression of that primordial battle between good and evil, the vow taken by Satan, by the shaitan, when he was cast out of heaven, that قَالَ رَبِّ بِمَا أَغْوَيْتَنِي لَأُزَيِّنَنَّ لَهُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَلَأُغْوِيَنَّهُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ. That he has vowed to send all of mankind astray, this enmity between him and the children of Adam. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promises that His servants will never be under the power of the shaitan. إِنَّ عِبَادِي لَيْسَ لَكَ عَلَيْهِمْ سُلْطَانٌ إِلَّا مَنِ اتَّبَعَكَ مِنَ الْغَاوِينَ. It is only those who choose to follow the shaitan who would be punished for that choice. And so Allah azza wa jal is the source of reward and also the source of punishment. All things come from Him and He is the Lord of all outcomes. نَبِّ عِبَادِي أَنِّي أَنَا الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. So in verse 49, tell my servants that I am the forgiving and the merciful. وَأَنَّ عَذَابِي هُوَ الْعَذَابُ الْأَلِيمُ. But on the other hand, that He says, my punishment is the painful punishment. In this surah, we have the accounts of a number of the prophets. There's Ibrahim alayhi salam and the guests who come to him. And then there is Lut alayhi salam and his people and how they were destroyed. And a mention of Shu'aib and his people. And a mention of the people of the Hijr in verse 80. And from them, the surah takes its name. In other words, they are the people of Thamud to whom the Prophet Salih was sent. And in the end of the surah, we have a command, an instruction, a guidance to the Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam to be patient, even though people may attack him and besmirch his name. إِنَّا كَفَيْنَاكَ الْمُسْتَهْزِئِينَ. That Allah Azza wa Jal says that we have taken upon ourselves to deal with those who mock you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So he is told to be patient. فَسَبِّحْ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّكَ وَكُمْ مِنَ السَّاجِدِينَ وَاعْبُدْ رَبَّكَ حَتَّى يَأْتِيَكَ الْيَقِينَ. And to worship Allah until that certain truth, which is death, would come to him sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And then in Surah An-Nahl, it begins with a verb which is in the past tense. So be patient because the command of Allah is coming. Indeed, in the knowledge of Allah, in Allah's perspective, it has already come. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Ata amrullahi fala tasta'jiluh. Subhanahu wa ta'ala amma yushrikun. the command of Allah has come indeed, so do not hasten it on. And Surah An-Nahl is full of recounting the ni'am and the favors from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Indeed, it is often known as Surah An-Ni'am. It mentions the cattle, the crops, the mountains, the sea routes, and many other things, culminating in the fact mentioned in verse 18 that we would never be able to count the favors of Allah even if we should attempt that. وَإِن تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَغَفُورٌ رَّحِيمٌ The prophets, may Allah's peace and blessings be upon them, were human beings. And this is emphasized in verse 43.
وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا مِن قَبْلِكَ إِلَّا رِجَالًا نُوحِي إِلَيْهِمْ فَاسْأَلُوا أَهْلَ الذِّكْرِ إِن كُنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ
So ask the people of remembrance if you do not know. And this includes the instruction to us to seek knowledge and to ask those who are endowed with knowledge if there is anything that we are unsure of.
بِالْبَيِّنَاتِ وَالزُّبُرِ وَأَنزَلْنَا إِلَيْكَ الذِّكْرَ لِتُبَيِّنَ لِلنَّاسِ مَا نُزِّلَ إِلَيْهِمْ وَلَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَفَكَّرُونَ
And above all, we are to ask the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who has been entrusted with clarifying the Quran, لِتُبَيِّنَ لِلنَّاسِ, to explain to us that which has been revealed to us. And this verse, like one that we saw previously in Surah Ali Imran, brings together the dhikr and the fikr, that scripture and reason exist together in harmony and in mutual support. In verse 68, we have the mention of the bee, after whom this chapter is named.
وَأَوْحَى رَبُّكَ إِلَى النَّحْلِ أَنِ اتَّخِذِي مِنَ الْجِبَالِ بُيُوتًا وَمِنَ الشَّجَرِ وَمِمَّا يَعْرِشُونَ
And it mentions that beautiful and pure and healing substance which comes from their body by Allah's will. And really, to understand these verses as so many verses of nature in the Quran, the best thing that we can do, as well as just reading books of tafsir, is to watch documentaries and for ourselves to study the creation and all the wonders therein. There is a verse coming later in the surah, verse 90, which summarizes some of the lofty values and principles of Islam.
إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْمُرُ بِالْعَدْلِ وَالْإِحْسَانِ وَإِيتَاءِ ذِي الْقُرْبَى وَيَنْهَى عَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنْكَرِ وَالْبَغِي يَعِظُكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَذَكَّرُونَ
Allah commands justice and goodness, benevolence and doing good to others, and giving to those kinfolk in need. And He forbids us from all kinds of immorality, wrongdoing and aggression. The end of Surah An-Nahl contains a verse about wisdom in calling people to the path of God.
ادعوا إلى سبيل ربك بالحكمة والموعظة الحسنة وجادلهم بالتي هي أحسن إن ربك هو أعلم بمن ضل عن سبيله وهو أعلم بالمهتدين
Invite to the path of your Lord with wisdom and beautiful preaching and debate with them or dialogue with them in ways that are better. Indeed, your Lord knows best those who have gone astray from His path, and He knows best those who are truly guided. وَصَلَّى اللَّهُ وَسَلَّمَ عَلَى سَيِّدِنَا مُحَمَّدٍ وَآخِرُ دَعْوَانَا أَنِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ